The topic is marginal distribution and conditional distribution. So let's do this example. Students were surveyed. A contingency table of eye color and gender is the following. So we have two variables, eye color, which is right here, and gender. All right, and then we have all these values. So let's answer these questions. What percent of students have brown eyes? So we need the number of students, right? So in other words, we need to do all those totals in the margin. So first thing we do, we try to find all the totals. So it's total. So 15 plus 20 is 35. 35 plus 8 is 33. So there are 33 totals, right? And then for the females, how many females have 5 plus 25 is 30. 30 plus 7 is 37. And then if we add 33 plus 37, we'll get 60, 70, right? And then we do the same thing. If we look at the column brown, 15 plus 5 will give you 20. 20 plus 25 will give you 45. 8 plus 7, it gives you 15. And then let's add, just to make sure we didn't make any mistake, 20 plus 45 is 65. 20 plus 45. See, something doesn't make sense. So if you go back to male, this is supposed to be 34. That's how you know you made a mistake or not. 15 plus 20 plus 8 is 43. Now everything makes sense. 43 plus 37 will be 80. Right? And then 20 plus 45 plus 15 will be 80. So I caught the mistake. All right, now let's answer the question. What percent of students have brown eyes? So what's the total of students? It's 80, right? So 80 always goes in the bottom. What percent of students? This always goes, whatever is after of goes in the denominator. So 80, what percent of students have brown eyes? So how many brown eyes we have? So this is it. 20 brown eyes. So you do 20 over 80, which is equal to 0.25. But 0.25 is just 25%. All you do, you move decimals, two decimals to the right. All right, now next question. What percent of students have green or other eyes? Again, what percent of students, number of students go to the bottom. So it's 80. Now we need to know what percent of students have green or other eyes. So we're talking about 15 of them. So it's 15 over 80. Use your calculator. It's 0.1875, which means 18.75%. Now, next question, what percent of males have brown eyes? Again, this time, we want to know what percent of males. So, number of males goes to the denominator. This is the number of males we have, 43. So 43 goes in the denominator, and we want the males that have brown eyes. So this is the number of males that have brown eyes, 15. So 15 over 43, use your calculator, it's 0.3488. which is 34.88%. Now, next question, what percent of females? Again, number of females will go to the denominator. How many females we have? 37 females. So 37 goes in the denominator and have blue eyes. How many females have blue eyes? 25. So it's 25 over 37. Use your calculator. It's 0.6756, which is 67.56%. Now, next question is, what is the marginal distribution of eye color? As soon as I hear marginal distribution of eye color, so eye color, automatically I know brown, blue, and green and other. So brown, blue, and then green or other. This is how it's distributed. And again, when it says marginal, that means we need to look at the margins, either this margin or this margin. We're looking at this row. In other words, we need to know how many have brown eyes. So it's going to be 20 over 80 for the brown. So 20 over 80. For the blue, it would be 45 out of the total of 80 students. So 45 over 80. And then the green would be 15 over 80. So we're only going to use this row, right? So the last one we said, 15 out of 80. Now all we have to do is use the calculator, right? All right, 20 divided by 80 is 0.25, which is 25%. And then 45 divided by 80 is 0.5625, which is 56.25%. And then 15 divided by 80, 0.1875, which is 18.75%. Now, next question is, what is the marginal distribution of gender? Again, as soon as we're looking at margins, but when you see distribution of gender, gender is what? Male and female. So, males and females. Right? I mean, how many males we have out of all the students and how many females? So this time, we need to look at this column, the other margin. So it's 43 over 80 for the males and 37 out of 80. So 43 over 80 and 37 over 80. So let's use a calculator, 43 over 80 is 0.5375, which is 53.75%, and 37 divided by 80 is 0.4625, which is 46.25%. And of course you can check your answer. If you add these percentages, you're gonna get 100%. Same thing, if you add all these percentages, you will get 100%. It's how you know if you made a mistake somewhere. All right, now we're gonna talk about the conditional distribution of eye color for males. So again, as soon as I see conditional distribution of eye colors, as soon as I see that eye color, I know these brown eyes, blue eyes, and then green or other. Right? Then I see it's for males, then I need to go and just check the males. In other words, I'm looking at this row. So it's gonna be 15 out of what? 43 males. And then 20 for the blue, 20 out of 43 males. And then for the green, 8 out of 43 males. So 15 out of 43. And then we said 20 out of 43. And then we said 8 out of 43. And again, we're just going to use a calculator. 15 divided by 43 is 0.3488, which is 34.88%. And then 20 divided by 43 is 0.4651, which is 46.51%. And then 8 divided by 43, which is 0.1860, which is 18.60%. Now, next question. Let's finish all the IMA. Actually, let's do 9 first and then 8. 9 is almost the same thing. What is the conditional distribution of eye color again? Again, of eye color, automatically you do brown. All the eye colors. Brown, blue, and then green or other. And then it says for females, means I'm going to look at this row, just females. So it's going to be 15 out of 37 female, 5 out of 37 females, 25 out of 37, and then 7 out of 37. So 5 out of 37. And then the blue will be 25 out of 37. And then the green would be 7 out of 37. Again, use a calculator. 5 divided by 37 will be 0.1351, which is 13.51%. And then 25 divided by 37, 0.67556, which is 67.56%. And then 7 divided by 37, which is 0.1891, which is 18.91%. Alright, now let's go back to number 8. Number 8, it's what is the conditional distribution of gender? Of what gender? So first, what is gender? We know it's male and female. And then it says, what is the conditional distribution of gender for brown eyes? Brown eyes. Where is brown eyes? Right here. So we need to look at this column, right? In other words, how many so we're looking, we said at this column, in other words, out of all the browns, how many are males, how many are females? So we have 15 males out of 20 brown eyes, and then 5 females out of the 20. So for the male it's going to be 15 out of 20. 15 out of 20, and then 5 out of 20, and then use your calculator. 15 divided by 20 is 0.75, which is 75%, and if you divide 5 by 20, we can even guess it should be 0.25. 25%, because remember when you add these, you're supposed to get 100%. So as soon as you find one, you can guess the other one. Now for number 10, what is the conditional distribution of gender? Again, we're doing the conditional distribution of gender means male, females. So how many males out of all the blue eyes? So we need to look at this column. How many out of all the blue eyes are males? And how many out of all the blue eyes are females? So males will be 20 out of 45. Females will be 25 out of 45. So 20 out of 45. And the females are 25 out of 45. So 20 divided by 45, which is 0.4444. 44.44%, and 25 divided by 45, 0.5555, which is 55.55%. We're almost done. What is the conditional distribution of gender? Again, gender, it's male and female. Right, how many out of all the green and other eyes, how many are males, how many are females? So we look at the green column. So males will be 8 out of the 15, and then female will be 7 out of the 15. So 8 out of 15, 7 out of 15. Divide 8 by 15. You get 0.5333, which is 53.33%. And then 7 divided by 15, which is 0.466, which is 666, which is 46.66%. And that's it for this example.